फटाफट सिलेक्ट करो भाई।
अभी तक वो आए नहीं, कितने जुड़े हैं इसमें?
सर सुनाई दे रहा है सर आपको? आवाज आ रही है सर? सर आवाज आ रही है?
आई कैन हियर यू।
यस सर, थैंक यू सर, थैंक यू वेरी मच।
से हो जाएगा ना? हाँ हाँ, इसको अनम्यूट करना पड़ेगा ना।
फर्स्ट अगस्त 2020 सैटरडे 10:10 प्रातः, थ्री डेज, फर्स्ट सेकेंड एंड थर्ड अगस्त, नेशनल स्मार्ट इंडिया हैकाथन 2020 के सॉफ्टवेयर एडिशन में आई सैल्यूट वन एंड ऑल फ्रॉम द लैंड ऑफ अयोध्या। Honorable Vice Chancellor Professor Ravi Shankar Singh is presiding over this inaugural session of IET Ayodhya Nodal Center Hackathon. As per custom, let's salute Goddess Saraswati by playing Saraswati Vandana in screen share mode. Request my team to play Saraswati Vandana to start the program. Buddhim Pradam Shardam, so that we come out with solutions to serve our country and citizens in better way through this Smart India Hackathon. Now, as per custom, it's time to play our Kul Geet. This Kul Geet, I request my team members to present in screen share mode. थैंक यू टीम। जहां श्री राम का घर है, जहां हनुमान का मंदिर, वहीं यह कला और विज्ञान का मंदिर डॉक्टर राम मनोहर लोहिया अवध विश्वविद्यालय अयोध्या में स्थित है। हम अयोध्या की इस पवित्र धरती से सभी को प्रणाम करते हैं। इस विश्वविद्यालय के माननीय कुलपति प्रोफेसर रविशंकर सिंह जी इस कार्यक्रम की अध्यक्षता कर रहे हैं। हमारे साथ 219 पार्टिसिपेंट्स इस समय अलोंग विद फैकल्टीज, अलोंग विद मेंटर्स, जूरी मेंबर्स इस समय अवेलेबल हैं। मैं सभी का स्वागत करता हूं, वंदन करता हूं, अपने यशस्वी कुलपति जी का विशेष रूप से आभार प्रकट करता हूं। कल ही सर ने कार्यभार ग्रहण किया और मेरे निवेदन से इस कार्यक्रम की अध्यक्षता को स्वीकार किया। ऐसे सुहृदय व्यक्तित्व वाले कुलपति जी का मैं इस कार्यक्रम में स्वागत करता हूं, वंदन करता हूं। हमारे बीच में श्रीमान विनीत गोयंका जी जुड़े हुए हैं, हम उनका स्वागत करते हैं। हमारी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी का बहुत ख्याल रखते हैं सर, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एचआरडी की तरफ से उन्होंने इसको इनोवेशन सेल के रूप में भी पहचान दिया है। हमारे बीच में अपनी बोर्ड ऑफ गवर्नर्स के चेयरमैन ऑनरेबल प्रोफेसर पीबी शर्मा सर जुड़ने वाले हैं, अभी उनका कनेक्ट हो नहीं पा रहा है। चीफ प्रोजेक्ट एडवाइजर न्यू दिल्ली एनपीआईयू से प्रोफेसर पीएम खोडके सर भी जुड़ने वाले हैं, ऐसा उन्हें हमें सूचना आई है। हम सभी का स्वागत करते हैं, वंदन करते हैं। नाउ आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑनरेबल श्रीमान विनीत गोयंका सर टू ब्लेस द स्टूडेंट्स एंड गाइड दिस स्मार्ट इंडिया हैकाथन सॉफ्टवेयर एडिशन 2020। ओवर टू यू सर।
नमस्ते, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल एंड माय प्रणाम्स टू द न्यू वाइस चांसलर एंड टू यू प्रोफेसर रामापति जी। इट्स ऑलवेज प्लेजर टू मीट यू एंड योर सो स्माइलिंग फेस। आपका जो हंसमुख चेहरा है बड़ा प्लेजर है। नए वाइस चांसलर साहब को बहुत बहुत बधाई। बहुत ही बढ़िया यूनिवर्सिटी है। मैं जब भी आता हूँ मुझे दो सुख मिलता है, एक तो स्टूडेंट्स के बीच में आने का, दूसरा वहां का जो वाइब्रेंट एनवायरमेंट अवध का, उसका मुझे बड़ा। सो आई एम जंपिंग ऑन दिस, आई एम नॉट टेकिंग नेम्स ऑफ एवरीबॉडी, बिकॉज़ वंस यू टेक रमापति जी'स नेम एंड वाइस चांसलर्स नेम, आई थिंक आई हैव टेकन ऑल द नेम्स ऑफ द प्रोफेसर्स। आई विल जंप ऑन दिस। आई एम ऑल्सो स्टूडेंट। आई हैव 15 मिनट्स हैज बीन टोल्ड टू मी एंड आई विल ट्राई टू बी इन 15 मिनट्स, नॉट एक्सीड माय 15 मिनट्स एट ऑल। Today being the day when we have to remember Lokmanya Tilak ji, also my pranams to him. It is his 100th memorial day, and we should all wish that we could get some learning from him. We also are in an era when we just saw 2-3 days back passing of the new national education policy, and our this meeting would help us to focus on various discussion, and this hackathon also leads what in. Now let me just compare my time when I was in my college days, in my graduation days. I passed out my post graduation in 1995. And many of the students who may be here right now in the hackathon would not have been born by that time. So what's the difference there? We used to learn so that we can pass the exam. We wanted to pass the exam so that we can get the degree. We wanted the degree because we could get jobs, and we wanted jobs because that was desperation that time. There was no other reason, very honestly. I had never a chance to be on the same platform where I had my director, my professors, or my vice chancellor sitting and discussing and listening to people. They used to go listen to some seminars, maybe that may be in months, in a quarter or so, come back and share their knowledge to us. But with the change of this and with the new thing, market has changed, environment has changed, and when there is a vibrant university like Awadh University and the students who are there, then they don't come to college or they don't learn just because they want to pass. they learn and they contribute because they would like to contribute back to this great motherland. And in place of becoming a job seeker, they all want to become a job giver. And what my experience when I came there twice, this is my fourth time I'm interacting, two times I had come there and two times I'm doing it online. Students of Awadh University don't want to do job, but they also want to give job in turn. That is the best thing. And what does this hackathon give it to us? It gives us an opportunity to discuss, understand what is the market after 10 years. When we are talking today in 2020, the students, the professors would like to discuss about what is going to be there in 2030, 2040. So that when a student passes out in the next 4 years, maybe in 2021 or 2024, when he passes out, he would like to get into a stream. He would like to get into some business or entrepreneur or some research, which would give not only revenue benefits, but also in turn, some service to the mankind. I'll give you one simple example. It was old days when, you know, you join a company somewhere as a junior officer or an assistant professor, and then slowly, gradually grow up. And by the time you become a decision maker, your zeal to take decisions was over. The energy which you wanted to do research was over. Now, these are a very conducive environment, a very good environment. There is a disruption. Students who just pass out and join as intern, they don't join as intern as subordinate to other people, but many times they directly join into innovation teams which can do innovations. One small example can be exchange, and which probably students may not understand, but the seniors will understand, is when we used to travel on the road, we used to ask 25 people, how would you go to that particular destination? If I wanted to come from Noida to Ayodhya University, it would have taken me at least 20-25 instances where I would have asked, bhaiya, aage kaise jana hai? And now with the help of map, you can directly go. Thus, what we have done is we have saved time, we have saved energy, and we have progressed. Now, let me come to what are the necessities of tomorrow. If you see the entire GDP, GDP compromises of, it has various components. One of the component which it has is core, which is maybe your minerals, maybe your agricultural produce, maybe your production. But it also has one component, and that component is innovation and services generated out of this innovation. I feel pinched whenever I see the comparison. India, with a population of 130 crore people, so many thousand crores opportunities we should have had. But in place of that, we only have filed 2,000 patents. As compared to us, if you see Japan, which has filed more than 50,000 patents. Now, we all know in this 2,000 plus patents which we have filed, half of them are academic patents. And what are academic patents? In an academic patent, what happens is you generally file the patent not with the purpose of getting it commercialized, but with an intention to just get some certification. Now, this does not lead to commercialization of patents and does not lead to making money. But we have opportunities now. If students can come out, join companies, start their own startups, innovation centers, where they could come out with some patentable product. Let me give an example. If we can generate some sort of IoT, which would be placed in the tractor, and when the tractor plucks the agricultural land, can we come out with information, which information tells us what is the thickness of the soil, what is the hardness of the soil, and can we decide what are the seeds which have to be used in that particular soil? And that will help us to plan what are the seeds to be used. Can this information be passed? Can we have some kind of integration of various data required by agriculturists? Now, how does the agriculture farming happen? Farming happens on soil, air, light, seed, and then various other processes, techniques which are used in soil. Now, if we can have a device, or we can communicate to the farmer, what is the meteorological information? What is the wind speed? What is the direction of the wind? What is the lumex of the sun? And how much is the heat of the sun? What will happen is, once we know this particular part, the farmer can decide whether he should do the sowing, spray the pesticides, do the harvesting, and he can plan his resources. This small information that tomorrow there will be a wind of 30 kilometers per hour, he may decide not to do his pesticides. If he knows that the winds are going to blow from north towards south, he may choose to spray his pesticide from the northern side to the southern side so that he does not inhale that pesticide and his health will be okay. Can we use integration of the moisture? Can we plant a small device in the soil which tells on the mobile what is the moisture level, and the farmer can choose to go and water the plants? Now, in place of flooding the plants with a lot of water and creating hydrophobia for the plants, or not giving water and creating shock for the plants, if we can appropriately plant water the plants, I think the production will go up. With the same things, other things being constant, the seed is constant, the procedure is constant, your soil is constant, your nutrients are constant. You just manipulate the water on the basis of the device which you generate, may probably give us a lot of. Now, let me go to one step ahead of this. Can the innovators come out with something which is of physics, where we have products? Now, I'll show you some products which I deliberately brought. We all see these products in our life. And what are these products in our life? So this is, I don't know what is the English name of this, but in Hindi, we call them as to be anjeer. We call this as aloo bukhara. Now, what are these? These are the dried, sun-dried products. Now, what happens is, when you bring these products, they are harvested. Post-harvesting, we have seen our grandmother or at a larger level of the farmer also, dries it in the sun. And then it is stored over the year. So in place of eating it instantly, within the small geography of where it has been produced, it is consumed over the world and the period of consumption is increased. But what happens when you do sun drying? Couple of things happen in sun drying and which we should know. One, what happens is it loses the ingredient, the nutrition's value, which is inside that. Number two, it loses the color. So if you see this anjeer, the color has gone. Somewhere it is light dark, somewhere it is very dark. Three, the taste also changes. The shape changes. Can we come out with a physics? Like we dry our wash clothes in washing machine, can we have a hydro extractor which removes the water molecules out of this so that the shape remains same, so that the nutrition values remain same, the taste remains same, but we can store the same anjeer over the period like we do it in sun drying. So what will happen is, while we retain the product, food product, over the period, we don't lose nutrition value. This will not only guarantee us the food supply, will also guarantee us the nutritional supply. And you know, Vice Chancellor will agree with me that today, if I, Vice Chancellor, and Professor Ramapatiji decide to go back to lab, it will not be very easy for us to come out with protocols. We may do it, but it will require a lot of mental thinking. And probably Professor Mishra or Paritosh also will agree that it will be a challenge for us to go back. But if a student of third year engineering would decide to do that, he may probably do it faster than what we do it. He may do it with lesser equipments, because his mind is not corrupt. His mind is not thought, been preoccupied with many things. He may think innovative, which probably we will not. And this hackathon gives that opportunity to think, how can we change interventions, technological interventions, which will change humanity, which will change the cost of living, maintaining the standard of living, or maintaining the cost of living, we increase the standard of living. Kis tarah se hum humare jeevan paddhati ko achha bana sakte, iske baare mein hum kar sakte. Small innovation, will it change? And you know, I had an opportunity to go to Vienna. I saw a machine where they cut banana, keep that banana in that machine, it extracts hydro out of it, and what happens is that cut banana can survive for 3 years. If you come to my house in Noida, I'll show you that banana which is there, which has been cut and been kept on my table at ambient temperature, at the room temperature, no refrigeration required, no chemical required, and 3 years. Just think about this. A major part of the problem of food, the food security can be achieved. This can be done by our students who are their partners. Now, let me go to another part. Can we eliminate corruption from the society? Can we eliminate middlemen from the society? We have seen that the e-portals which have come up, the e-marketplaces which has been given by the government, generated opportunity for farmers to connect with the, and that eliminated middlemen. And when I was appointed on the railways, I come from a lower middle class family. My entire family traveled from train. We always traveled in the normal sleeper class. We had never traveled in air-conditioned class till I became graduate. So I knew a couple of problems, and I shared this problem once I was there with Professor Ramapatiji there in your university. One of the biggest problem is the train comes at odd hour. The train may come at 4 o'clock at your station. Now, if the train is coming in the morning, 4 o'clock at your station, you may have to move out of your house before that, calculating how much is the distance. See, if you're staying half an hour away, you may have to move out from your house at 2 o'clock in the morning. Now, we all know if a young girl has to move out at 2 o'clock in the morning from the house to go to railway station, the entire family would be worried. And what would happen is, there is one, pain to get up in morning, 2 o'clock, uncomfortable. Then you go there. Number two, then there is a fear in the mind that this is all over and what will happen if you are there on the station alone. And the problem aggravates if the train comes in the morning, 9 o'clock or 10 o'clock. 2 baje train agar 10 baje aati hai aur 2 baje aap ghar se nikle to woh. What simple thing railway did is, we incorporated technology. We put in an ISRO provided device on our locomotives. Now you know exactly where your train is with a plus or minus 3 minutes notification. Now, if your train was scheduled to come at 2 o'clock in the morning, but if it is going to arrive at 7 or 8 in the morning, you would know about that. You would not move out of your house. What will happen is, we may not be able to improve the efficiency, but we will be able to at least save your time, your pain from reaching the station. Now, this was simply possible by incorporating certain technological changes provided by ISRO on rail. Now, I had never thought, but when the Prime Minister gave us this vision that we are bonded to tell the passengers what time the train is going to come, the initial immediate reaction came to mind is, Google map hai na, usi ko bata denge, usi se bata sakte. But then when I was on the board and I said my board, no, we cannot use Google map. And we also had Major General Lamba, he also said, you cannot use Google map. Why we cannot use Google map? And this is what I think is the opportunity I wanted to talk to you all students is, Google map may give you precision of plus or minus 20 seconds, but the data flows out of my country to another country. Railway not only carries civilian population, but also carries my people in uniform. It not only carries goods and services, goods and other cargo of civilians, but also carries goods and cargo which are called as strategic. Now, will I like to know any other country about the data, about my travel? Just think, if somebody comes out and gives me the manifest of the passengers which are traveling in the train, it will be an embarrassment. So we wanted an indigenous technology, in-house technology. We took some time. We had to approach ISRO. We took help of BEL. We made this. We took time and it was a little expensive also. While we delivered this and we were very happy that now passengers, the trade would know what time the train is going to available. But there is a pain in our mind. And that pain which I would like to share with you right now, students, and if you can help me out to remove that pain. I was not successful to remove this pain. But I'm pleading to you, I'm folding my hands and requesting you if you can remove this pain. Every step of the innovation, every step of migration of the technology, we thought that jaake unki technology kharid lete, apna wala ho nahi raha. That pain is still in my mind. If we can generate, we can innovate technologies in-house where we don't have to have that doubt in the mind, where we never think that we will go and buy their technology, where my 3 days, my people who will succeed my office, who will come after me, do not have to go through that pain of comparison between Indian technology versus foreign technology. If that comes out, I think probably that will be an achievement for me and your Vice Chancellor, that we had a next generation who would do better than our generation. If you can innovate, replace importable technology, nothing like it. One major part of inflation is the cost of import. Whenever you import something, not only that you lose foreign exchange, but it also gives burden to the taxpayer. It also gives burden to this society by way of inflation. Every time when you import, can we have an import replacement of fossil fuel? Can we generate green fuel inside the country? Can we have vehicles which will use lesser fossil fuel? Can we have technologies like we are talking right now? It is such a nice way. It is a green way. I didn't travel to Ayodhya. You don't have to spend on my logistic, but we could see each other, listen to each other at comfort of our own house. But the pain is we are using a foreign technology. Can we have our own video conferencing system where we generate data, retain the data? So my last part of my speech is, sovereignty is very big thing. And for sovereignty, you have to pay a price. Our fathers, they fought the freedom struggle. Many of them sacrificed themselves to give us freedom. This freedom will not be sustained if we don't have sovereignty. And sovereignty is not only military sovereignty. It is not only sovereignty by physical boundaries of the country. it is also economical sovereignty. Economical sovereignty comes only when you have technological sovereignty, and technological sovereignty will come only when we have innovation, and innovations can only come when we have hackathons like this and we have able vice chancellor and professors like what I see on my screen right now. I would like to once again thank Dr. Ram Manohar Lohia, Awadh Vishwavidyalaya, Honorable Vice Chancellor Sahab, Honorable Director Sahab, every professor and the students who have heard me. I hope I kept my promise of 15 minutes in front of you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Honorable Vineet Goenka, sir. Your motivation and guidance to students means a lot. You are the leader for young generation engineers. आपने छात्रों को बताया सर, इट्स ऑलवेज गुड टू बिकम एंटरप्रेन्योर एंड जॉब प्रोवाइडर, और आपने एक नई दिशा दिया है, इंटरनेट ऑफ थिंग्स इज द न्यू एरिया जहां स्टूडेंट्स कैन डू ए लॉट, इवन एग्रीकल्चरल फार्मिंग, और आपने ट्रैक्टर्स पर भी इसका उपयोग करना बताया है. योर इनोवेटिव आइडियाज मीन ए लॉट टू वी इंजीनियर्स इन कॉलेजेस ऑल्सो सर. बहुत अच्छा लगा है, थैंक यू सो मच सर. हमसे जुड़ चुके हैं प्रोफेसर, ऑनरेबल प्रोफेसर पीएम खोडके सर, चीफ प्रोजेक्ट एडवाइजर एनपीआईयू न्यू दिल्ली हैं. आई वेलकम यू ऑनरेबल सर एंड सैल्यूट यू फ्रॉम दिस लैंड ऑफ अयोध्या. सर को अभी एमएचआरडी की मीटिंग में जाना है, मैंने रिक्वेस्ट किया इसलिए वो जुड़ गए हैं. सर की प्रेजेंस ही हमारे लिए काफी मोटिवेशन रहती है आगे अपने बीच में बात करने के लिए. डॉक्टर अभय सिंह रजावत हैं, एमएचआरडी इनोवेशन सेल से सिंगल पर्सन ऑफ कॉन्टैक्ट एसपीओसी फॉर दिस सेंटर. आई विल रिक्वेस्ट हिम टू डिस्कस डूज एंड डोंट्स इंस्ट्रक्शंस फॉर पार्टिसिपेंट्स. Over to you, Dr. Abhay Singh Rajawat. Are you able to listen me, sir? I welcome and invite Dr. Abhay Singh Rajawat, sir. If you are able to listen me, kindly come and discuss do's and don'ts instructions for the participants in this. नहीं वो आई थिंक वो नेटवर्क से बाहर है, वो जुड़े थे रजावत सर, जुड़े थे. अजय रजावत हैं सर, इज नॉट एबल टू लिसन आई थिंक
सर. एक्चुअली आई वॉज म्यूटेड एट दैट टाइम, रियली सॉरी
सर. सर सर ओवर टू यू सर नाउ. सो नाइस सर. डॉक्टर रजावत सर वेलकम सर.
Sir, thank you for providing me opportunity to just to talk on some do's and don'ts. Actually, you can also see like we are in a rush here, and I would like to first of all like thank Director Sir and the Vice Chancellor Sir of IIT Ayodhya along with Paritosh Ji. They are working so hard to make it possible because we are right now in that kind of stage that either we have to go ahead or we can just stop ourselves. So here for the consideration, I would like to tell teams that I think I was in interaction with you from a long time since the group, and the thing is, initially when we talk about this do's and don'ts, we have to take care of all the protocols. Okay, so there are four points that I want to discuss. Is first thing is, if like your NC is directing you to do something, you have to do it at an urgent basis. Secondly, your mentors needs to be on board if they are from your college, and if you need any kind of clarification, the whole MIC team is here to assist you further. Okay, coming to the third point, it's really necessary to take care of you can say the things that are not valid in a that kind of online hackathon that your IP is bounded with your Slack channel. So any fishy thing going on, we are going to detect it here. We are having a centralized control room here. So I request you all not to share your Slack email and password to anyone, because in case if you are able to crack some kind of non-invasive things here, we are definitely going to detect it later. So don't use such proxies and VPNs so that your team disqualification needs to be done from here. I'm not saying that you all are finalists, so I don't have to repeat this thing again and again, but that is completely fine. And the last is the most important one. Guys, code really hard. You are working for a national development, and very rare students had this opportunity. All the senior dignitaries who have joined here from technical background might be in, at their time, there was not having any hackathon model. So it's my request you to code hard, code well, and just for 3 days, just think like you are working in an IT company and you are sitting on your desk and you're having a project in hand, and just deliver the solution that is needed. Whenever there is a kind of help is needed, I'm always there. Like since from last 1 month, I'm interacting with you guys. Whole MIC team is here to assist you. I just want IIT Ayodhya to perform well. And we want some winners from your side. Rest, I think the NC manpower and coordinators are capable enough of handling all the issues, real-time operations issues. But yes, code well, guys. We are counting on you, and you are just submitting your a pinch in the national development. Not everyone is getting the chance to build something for the nation. That's done from my side. Director sir, over to you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Abhay Singh Rajawat ji. My dear participants, किसी भी गेम के रूल्स होते हैं, रेगुलेशंस होते हैं, उसी प्रकार स्मार्ट इंडिया हैकाथन के भी रूल्स हैं, और डॉक्टर अभय सिंह ने सभी छात्रों को इसकी ट्रेनिंग दिया है. आई थैंक यू डॉक्टर अभय सिंह जी ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स एंड स्पेशली आईटी अयोध्या. नाउ वी हैव आवर ऑनरेबल वाइस चांसलर प्रोफेसर रविशंकर सिंह जी टू ब्लेस अस एंड गाइड अस फॉर द सक्सेसफुल होस्टिंग एंड कंप्लीशन ऑफ दिस स्मार्ट इंडिया हैकाथन 2020. ओवर टू यू ऑनरेबल सर.
ओके, थैंक यू प्रोफेसर रमापति मिश्रा जी. ऑनरेबल चीफ गेस्ट श्री विनीत गोयनका साहब, मेंबर ऑफ गवर्निंग काउंसिल मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ रेलवे गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया, ऑनरेबल गेस्ट ऑफ ऑनर प्रोफेसर पीएम खुटके सीपीए एनपीआईयू न्यू दिल्ली, गेस्ट ऑफ ऑनर प्रोफेसर पीबी शर्मा जी बीओजी चेयरमैन वाइस चांसलर अमित यूनिवर्सिटी हरियाणा, और डायरेक्टर आईईटी प्रोफेसर रमापति मिश्रा जी एंड एमएचआरडी इनोवेशन सेल एसपीओसी मिस्टर अजय सिंह राजावत. आई एम प्राउड टू अटेंड दिस इम्पॉर्टेंट मीटिंग एंड गैदरिंग. एज यू ऑल नो, हैकाथॉन हैज बिकम ए सॉर्ट ऑफ एकेडमिक स्पोर्टिंग इवेंट नाउडेज. दिस इज अ न्यू टूल एंड अप्रोच इन प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग एंड इट इज हेल्पिंग इन फाइंडिंग द many problems of the students. In my university, I have been informed that IIT Ayodhya has conducted 2 hackathons on demand by student and for the student. I am able to see the smiling faces of participating students from different reputed engineering colleges, which overjoys me. I wish all the success to these building engineers drawn from different engineering colleges of our country. I will remain connected to this event through host director IIT Professor Ramapati Mishra and ensure that no student faces any problem. All the best and best of luck. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. And the new thing, Honorable Vice Chancellor has said that hackathon has become academic sporting activity. Yes, sir. हम भी आपको बता दें कि इधर के रिसेंट डेज में इंजीनियरिंग के छात्र इसको बहुत लाइक करते हैं. दे कम सर. थैंक यू सो मच सर फॉर योर ब्लेसिंग्स एंड सर्टेनली वी विल लिव अप टू योर एक्सपेक्टेशंस फॉर दिस स्मार्ट इंडिया हैकाथन सॉफ्टवेयर एडिशन 2020 फ्रॉम कंडक्टेड फ्रॉम 1st August टू 3rd August. थैंक यू सो मच सर. Now it's time to pay thanks to everybody. So I will request faculty engineer Shambhavi Shukla, madam, to come and pay thanks to everyone. Over to you, Shambhavi.
Thank you so much, sir. A warm and graceful morning to everyone. It is my privilege to have been asked to propose a vote of thanks on this occasion. I, Shambhavi Shukla, as a co-convener of the event, on behalf of the entire fraternity of Institute of Engineering and Technology and organizing team, I'd like to express our profound gratitude to the Honorable Vice Chancellor of Dr. Ram Manohar Lohia Awadh University, Professor Ravi Shankar Singh sir, for all words of wisdom that radiated a source of energy within us. Thank you for blessing us with your inspiring words and presence. Thank you for taking out valuable time of your busy schedule. We will always remain grateful to you for being with us today. I wish to show my deepest gratitude to Engineer Ajay Singh Rajawat sir, SPOC MHRD Innovation Cell, for sharing the important instruction with us and our students, as it is very important to know the do's and don'ts to ensure the success of any event. Thank you, sir. I deemed it a great honor to propose the vote of thanks to our guest of honor of this event, Professor. My gratitude to our director, sir, Professor Ramapati Mishra, sir. As you mentioned earlier, sir had served Indian Air Force after he had given his service to various reputed educational institutes as professor and director. Our director, sir, has always providing encouragement, motivation, and support is in his true personality. As a leader of our institute, he is full of energy. He is always guide us to be sincere, punctual, and to be true to our work. I am very grateful to director, sir, for giving us an opportunity to organize this event. Now, I would like to express my vote of thanks to our guest of honor of this event, Engineer Vineet Goenka, sir, for his kind words and to be there for us always. Sir, thank you for being with us always. I'd like to take this opportunity to place on record our hearty thanks to panel of juries and judges, as they have key role in sorting out the best teams among thousands. I wish to encourage them and I wish to congratulate them for the evaluation and result which is going to happen in coming days. I must mention my deepest gratitude for the vigilance officer assigned to our institution. I congratulate to the participants for active and sincere participation in this event, which lead them here at this platform. 17,000 teams have been applied for the SIH, and you all are among those few teams which has made to reach at this platform. Heartiest congratulations and all the best, all of you. Event like this cannot happen overnight. The wheels start rolling months ago. It is required planning and a bird's eye view for details. we have been fortunate enough to have Parthvi ma'am, and I already mentioned Ajay Rajawat sir, who know their job and are result oriented. Thank you for taking valuable time for various meetings we all had in last few weeks. I also extend thanks to our SPOC, Mr. Paitosh Tripathi sir, for his enormous effort to organize this gala event, as no program can become successful with a single person. So I extend my big thanks to our team of mentors for their support. Engineer Amitesh Pandit, Engineer Mahesh Chaurasia, Engineer Deepak Kori, Engineer Ashish Gupta, Engineer Shobhit Srivastava, Engineer K.L. Pandey, Engineer Asta Singh Kushwaha, Engineer Akhilesh Maurya, and Engineer Naveel Patel, sir. Thank you, everyone. I must mention our deep sense of appreciation for Engineer Ramesh Mishra, sir, Engineer Amit Bhati, sir, and Engineer Vineet Singh, sir, for their work. I would like to thank the convener of the event, Engineer Parimal Tiwari, sir, for his efforts. I cannot thank everyone enough for their involvement and willingness to take on the completion of tasks beyond their comfort zones. I also thanks to the guests of honors who have been not connected with us right now, but thank you for taking the time they have given us for the event. Thank you very much. Least but not the last, we are really very much owed to Almighty, and I continuously pray to the Omnipresent to provide us such opportunities in plenty. Thanks a lot to one and all directly or indirectly involved in the program. Thank you all. Namaste from land of Ayodhya.
Thank you, Engineer Shambhavi. Now it's time for national anthem. Rashtragan ke baad hi we will sign off. So I will request my team to share national anthem, Rashtragan.
जन गण मन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्तर बंगला विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उज्जल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मागे गाहे तव जयकारा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
जय
भारत माता की जय
थैंक यू सर थैंक यू एवरीवन
थैंक्स सर को बुला दे रहे हैं सर एक फोटो हो जाए जिससे
ओके ओके ओके